1 year has passed since I bought my first professional video camera, the Sony F3. Why am I gonna talk about this old heavy camera? Well, it has been my workhorse for the last year. An interest in this camera kinda spiked after Caleb at Dslrvideoshooter made a video about it. I have a comparison video comparing this camera to some mirrorless cameras and my Ursa 4K, and I got some comments asking me to show more footage from this camera. So here we go.
Ett gott psykiskt arv är guld värt i ett modernt samhälle, i en modern storstad.
Anyway, at that time he popped me two questions. That very morning I was going to get receive this prize, he popped me two questions that I have been pondering ever since. And the first one was, I was tying my tie, and he shouts from the bathroom, "Dad, I got to ask you something." It's like, "Go, son, go." And I go, "Pop, what? Because I've heard down in school that you received this prize, and I'm wondering, what is it that you do?" Which in and by itself is a pretty good question. However, of course, the follow-up was even better. The follow-up was, why is it important?
Why did I buy this camera? Well, I just basically wanted something that looked a little bit better than my mirrorless cameras. I came across a couple of comments on forums. I'm paraphrasing now, but the FS7's image quality is that of a toy camera compared to the F3, or I don't know what kind of magic they used back in the days when they created the color science of the F3. And I understand what they're saying. There is truly something special about this camera's sensor. It's a full HD sensor only, but it's very sharp and the color is great. This is not like shooting with a mirrorless camera with S-Log 2. This picture grades way easier and is way more color accurate. I found this one on an auction in Australia. I paid $1,500, but with shipping and customs, I ended up paying around $2,500 for it. I wanted 444 RGB upgrade, which is the latest firmware, and I also really wanted Reality Technica's cinevised F3 body, which removes the viewfinder and top handle and the zoom rocker, so you can customize it however you want it, which is nice. It didn't bother me that I paid a little bit more for it. I bought a Nikon mount for it. I mainly use Nikon lenses because you can pretty much fit them on any other camera. I have never shot this camera with its internal recording. I don't even have S-by-X cards or an SD adapter for it. I mainly record externally to my Atomos Ninja 5. There was a huge issue using the Atomos recorder with this camera. These older cameras, they only output a 50i signal, which then has to be converted or pulled down to become a 25p signal. The problem was that you have to go into the menu and set it to pull down. And every time you turned off the camera or the recorder, it would automatically go back to record 25i, which basically only gave you half the resolution. Looks like. I emailed Atomos about this, and in the next firmware, they set the pull down to default. So now every time you plug the camera in, it's just basically record and go, which is nice. Thanks, Atomos. When I first used this screen, I really thought it looked awful. These older LCD screens, they are quite horrible. But it's sharp enough to pull focus on. And when you use an external monitor, since it's outputting this 1080i signal, you only have half the resolution because it gives you two half frames, but the Ninja only shows you the half frame, which makes the image kind of like a 720p image, and it's actually kind of hard to pull focus on it. So nowadays I use the shuttle as my recorder, and I actually just use the original screen. I would of course use the monitor if there was a bigger shoot. Unfortunately, I never really used this camera as a cinema camera, more like a broadcast camera. I mainly film live events, seminars, presentations, and so on. This camera can shoot in extended clear scan mode, which basically is that you can fine-tune the shutter so you can remove flicker from a projector. The clients usually says, wow, nice picture quality.
Jag har problem med gravitationen. Alltså jag lyfter typ inte längre ens. Det hände ingenting när jag försökte hoppa. Jag sitter stilla bara.
Jag har inte fel ute. Jag sitter stilla på den här stället. Nej tack. Ja tack.
Det är det senaste. Det här är ju då egentligen en vampyrfilm. Så att i slutet av filmen så kommer de att öppna käften. Och så blir det en så kallad cliffhanger.
So, is this camera worth keeping for 2021? I've been thinking a lot about it. And I think the answer is yes, I am going to keep it. I still want to make a film with it someday.